First, we had Amazon and eBay. Then we had Wish.com. And now I'm starting to really see a lot of budget guitar gear being sold on Temu. And Temu's what's hot right now. We are living in the age of Temu. And I just so happened to be scrolling through Temu one day, and I ran across some guitar pedals for about 20 bucks each. So I bought the entire stock. I bought all 7 different pedals from this brand. And my question is, do you guys think that the budget guitar gear world is a little bit out of control? Well, we're about to find out. Let's see if any of these pedals are any good. Let's get into it. So like I said, I went on to Temu and I bought 7 different pedals from a company called Kate. I am not familiar with them. All I know is that they are out of China and that their pedals are tiny. These things are so small. If the boxes are this small, you know the pedals are going to be extremely miniature in size. So I know nothing else about this company. So let's go ahead and unbox these pedals and let's test them out individually and see if any of them are actually any good. So first up, we have the metal drive pedal. I'm a huge fan of tube screamers and drive pedals to go to the front of my amplifier. So I figured this was a great one to start out with. So let's go ahead. Let's get into this guy. Let's see here. Yeah, these guys are absolutely tiny. I mean, I feel like the palm of my hand is bigger than this pedal. That is crazy. Okay, so this is the drive. Let's plug it in. Let's find out what's going on with it. It's got a gain, a level, a tone, and a high and low switch. Obviously, also the bypass switch as well. But feeling it, it feels a little sharp around the edges. It's like they cut the metal and then they just went, okay, send it off. It's fine. They get metal splinters. It's all right. Huh. Okay, let's get into it. Alright guys, the ultimate drive. You know, not too bad actually. I was really pleasantly surprised with this pedal. It was mean, it was aggressive, it was filthy, it was what I was looking for in a boost pedal. Though one thing took me by surprise, and when I turned it on, all the lows came in as well. I think it just took the whole spectrum of the EQ and just kind of pushed everything. So what I would do to keep down on a lot of the muddiness that you guys heard in some of the areas is use an EQ pedal, and I would shelf off some of those lows just to keep down on that muddiness and keep it nice and tight like a modern boost pedal that I would use. On to the next one. Next up is the crunch distortion. So I don't really use a lot of crunchy tones. I use more of like high gain distorted tones, but we're gonna see a lot of pedals today that I don't usually work around with. So this is the crunch distortion. Let's go ahead and get into it, I guess. See what we got going on. These pedals are so small. I feel like I'm gonna break them. Actually, they don't feel too bad. It feels like a pretty heavy duty construction, but wow. I like the color on this one. The color is really nice. You have a true bypass, there is a gain, a volume, a tone, and then you're in and out and all that. So that is the crunch distortion. Let's check this guy out. The crunch distortion had a lot more distortion than I was expecting. I would actually consider this a high gain pedal versus a crunchy pedal. The gain and volume knobs were a little confusing because the volume knob kind of acted like a gain knob and vice versa at times, kind of making it hard to balance the two. The tone knob was like a single EQ knob, so it just kind of sweeped the spectrum and you would set it to your liking. I wish there was just a little bit more of the high-end frequencies in this guy and maybe a little bit less of the honkiness in the middle. I don't know if you guys heard that at all, but it kind of has an 80s vibe to it. I dig it. Next pedal, please. Next up on the roster is the Vintage Overdrive. So let's go ahead and unbox this guy. Let's see what we have going on here. And you know, first, before I get into this, I will say probably the most exciting part of this unboxing is to see what color the pedal's gonna be. I'm extremely color driven. I love my colors. So let's get into it here. Oh, I think it's gonna be a green pedal. I think it's gonna be my favorite color. Oh, the bag's got a little tear in the side. Okay. Oh, that is so cool. You know, I can really get behind how these pedals look. These pedals look really nice, actually. So it's like a nice spearmint green. So this is the Vintage Overdrive. We have a drive, a volume, a tone, and a true bypass, and then obviously the in and out. So let's go ahead and check out the Vintage Overdrive. The Vintage Overdrive is not my typical cup of tea, I will say, but I did not hate this pedal. I actually kind of liked it for more of like those crunchy, clean, and more emotional areas, or I could even see it going really well with a country band. To have that just overdriven guitar with that little bit of edge behind the band and everything, yeah, I can definitely see that. And I would say this is more of a crunchy tone than the crunchy distortion was, and plus, the drive and volume knob were a lot easier to control on this pedal. Let's see what we got next. So the next pedal is the US Dream, and I am curious, just from the name of it, do you think it's going to be a distortion pedal modeled after a 5150 or maybe a Mesa Boogie? I don't know, we're going to find out. So let's go ahead and get into this. And these colors, guys, the colors are the best part. You guys are here for the colors, right? That's what I thought. All right, let's pull this guy out of here. These are so great. These are awesome little guys. I love this. This is the US Dream. It's like a nice pink, purple, like a berry color, maybe. And I will say, it feels I was going to say it felt better feeling around the edges, but then I found a sharp part. So watch your fingers if you get these pedals, guys. One thing I will mention with these pedals that I really like, the grips on the back of them. They don't feel super cheap or anything, and they're actually really, really nice. They really grab onto your table pretty nicely, honestly. So that's kind of a nice little addition to these Kate pedals. All right, let's check out the US Dream. Thank you. US Dream is the first letdown today. I do not like this pedal. To me, this pedal sounds awful. It is really low, it is really fuzzy and muddy, it is just horrible. And no matter what I did to it, I couldn't quite get enough high-end frequencies to combat the low that was just overwhelming everything else. So for me, I would say the US Dream is a no-go. So let's see what we have going on next. Next up is the Tremolo pedal. So I remember messing with a Tremolo back in the day with my Spider 3 from Line 6, and it was kind of fun. It was just kind of a fun effect to mess around with. So let's go ahead and unbox this guy. Let's see what color it is. We'll see. It's all about the color. All about it. Oh, nice. Kind of classy. Let me get it out of the box. It's a nice shade of gold. Very classy. Very elegant. I like it. And we have a picture of a bowl on it. For what reason, I am unsure. But anyways, we have an intensity and we have a rate on the tremolo. So let's go ahead and check it out. Stepping even further out of my comfort zone is the Tremolo pedal. This is a fun pedal to mess around with. It's not in my usual style, but from time to time, I like to mess around with these things. The intensity knob, I expected it when it was turned all the way up to have a really sharp cutoff, but it was still fairly smooth, so it's not a really powerful intensity knob. And how I would use this pedal is have a very, very pristine, clean guitar tone and set the intensity at medium and also the rate at medium as well. That's how I would use it. Let's see what the next pedal is. So the second to last pedal that we are checking out today is the digital delay. So it'll be really cool to have a digital delay in here because we're gonna be able to add a little bit of ambiance to some of our sounds. So let's go ahead, let's unbox this guy. Let me find the opening here and check out what we got going on here. That's kind of like a nice mauve color. And for those of you that don't know what mauve is, you're about to find out. There we go. Got it. This is nice. It's kind of like a, it's mauve is kind of like a, it's like a purple beigey type of thing. Yeah. So really, I guess I'm confirming that we are here for the color rather than the pedal. But this is the digital delay. We have a time, a level, a repeat, in, out, bypass. It's all looking good. Let's check it out. So this one's going to be a really short one because I loved the digital delay pedal. This thing sounded great. It was everything I expected out of a digital delay echo pedal. It sounded great to me. I could do a slapback. I could do a longer delay if I really wanted to. It sounded awesome. So I would say this is probably my favorite pedal out of all of them today so far. Let's see if the final pedal can knock the digital delay off its throne. And the final pedal that we're going to be checking out today is the analog chorus. So I don't use a lot of choruses, but I know they can be really nice on some clean tones, kind of add some watery ambiance and stuff like that. So let's get into this guy. I hope it's blue. I don't know what color it is. Oh, I'm partly right, kind of. I don't know. Let's get it out of here. Oh yeah, it's kind of like a sky blue? Very nice. So this is the analog chorus. It's like a nice kind of sky blue. I don't hate it. I almost wish it was a little bit of a deeper blue, but that's all right. It's not about the looks of the pedal. It's about how it sounds. Very nice. We have a rate and we have a depth, the true bypass and the in and out. So let's see how the analog chorus will sound. You know, guys, I didn't think that any other pedal was going to keep up with the digital delay pedal, but the analog chorus, guys, this thing sounded So good. I loved it. I could do so many different chorus effects with it. I could go crazy intense and just get out of control with it. Or I could do something a little bit more subtle and a little bit more pristine. I really liked how the analog chorus sounded. This one probably doesn't beat the digital delay pedal, but it ties with it. Both of those pedals were absolutely amazing, and they kicked the butt out of every other pedal on this review. So yeah, analog chorus. For sure. Sounds awesome. I had a lot of fun checking out these pedals today. It was really cool to see which ones I didn't like, which ones I liked, and which ones I really, really liked. And with the analog chorus and the digital delay aside, if I had a choice between my more expensive distortion pedals and the Kate pedals that I checked out today, I would probably still choose the more expensive distortion pedals just because I like the tonal range that's on those ones a little bit more. And it's not saying that the Kate pedals are bad in any way, shape, or form, except for the US Dream. That one was not very good in my opinion. But if you are looking for a truly budget, like $20 pedal, you can go on to Temu and check out the Kate pedals for yourself, and you will definitely find what you are looking for. But I want to hear, what did you guys think? Please let me know down in the comments, what did you think of the different tones that you heard today? I'm really excited to see what you guys have to say. If you are enjoying my videos in any way, shape, or form, please consider hitting that subscribe button. It helps me out a ton here on the channel. And with that said, my name is Chris with High Impact Audio, and I will see you guys next time.